Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. My guest this week, the world's largest athlete, The Big Show.
Cool.
Let's start with your triple threat match for the Intercontinental Championship that takes place live on the WWE Network from St. Louis on July 19th, WWE Battleground. Ryback defends against you and The Miz. Now, you joined us on commentary this past Monday night on Raw, and it didn't seem like you really believe that Miz should be a part of this match.
Do you think Miz should be a part of this match? This is a triple threat for the Intercontinental Championship. What part of threat does Miz pose? The best thing Miz can do is hide somewhere and pray he doesn't get caught between Ryback and I and get torn in half. Miz has no business being around the Intercontinental Championship, nor does he have any business being in this match. Somehow he weaseled his way in. I'm pretty sure he's going to be sad he's even involved.
Let's talk about Ryback. You know, Big Show, for 20 years, you've dominated this industry. For Ryback, it's been a struggle. He was an alumnus from Tough Enough. Oh. He worked in our developmental system down in Florida.
Really?
Suffered through a number of injuries.
Oh, shame.
And finally won his first major championship back at Elimination Chamber. Many people think at this stage in his career, Ryback is hungrier than you are.
Ryback's hungrier than I am? Ryback thinks he's hungry. Ryback has no idea what it takes to compete at this level. Ryback's like a dog chasing a car. He thinks he wants to catch the car. He doesn't realize when he catches the car, he has no idea what to do with it. That Intercontinental Championship belongs to some of the greatest champions of all time. Pat Patterson, Randy Savage, Ricky Steamboat. In my career, I've only held that championship once. And Ryback wants to lay claim to the prestige of that title? No, I don't think so. Ryback has no business having the Intercontinental Championship. Everybody has a sad story. So what?
You know, many in the WWE universe believe that it's Ryback's time and that perhaps it's time for you to move on. Arenas that we go to throughout the world, when you're in the ring, many times they're chanting, please retire. Does that get under your skin?
Under my skin? No. It amuses me. Why would I retire? Would that help the WWE universe make the bad man go away? I'm not going to retire, and nobody can make me retire. I've been in this business for 20 years. I have fought, I have clawed, and I have dug to get to my position and to keep my position. And why would I give it up when I'm still making so much money and I'm still dominating? Why retire? Never.
Many would say that that attitude right there is one of the reasons that you haven't endeared yourself to the WWE universe, but yet Ryback has, because of his emotion. The story that he told this past Monday on Raw about how his parents were brought together for the first time in 15 years when he won the championship.
For 15 years, they haven't been together? I don't care. I don't care about his sad story. Everybody's got a story, Cole. You know what, if I have my way about it, it'd be another 15 years for his parents to get together. Ryback wants to endear himself to the WWE Universe. Why? That's the problem with Ryback. He's a fraud. His little chance. Feed me more. Chant along with me. Support me. Root for me. You know, I suppose a guy for what he is. He doesn't belong in the WWE. Ryback is a popular flash in the pan. He's here today and gone tomorrow. I am what's permanent. I am the only big guy here.
Show, you called Ryback Monday night an itty bitty boy.
It was kind of funny, wasn't it?
Ryback didn't find the humor. In fact, that itty bitty boy took you out on Raw.
Cole, Even her broken watch is right twice a day. Ryback got lucky. Good for him. Ryback doesn't stand a chance against me at Battleground. I'll expose Ryback, and I will take the Intercontinental Championship from Ryback. I've been here for 20 years, Cole. Do you think I'm gonna let that slide? Do you think I'm gonna let Ryback get away with that without having some kind of a payback, some kind of retribution? How do you think I've lasted this long? 20 years at the top. Why? Ask yourself why. Is it because I'm the greatest giant that's ever set foot in this business? Is it because of my overwhelming personality? I've lasted at the top because I have friends, very close friends, friends that are at the top.